When you're planning a trip to Iceland, one of the major things that you have to be concerned with is what kind of outlets do they have? What do you need in order to plug your devices into the wall in Iceland? That's what we're talking about today, friends. Hello Team Iceland, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jeannie and I am your tour guide for all things Iceland planning. Today, we are talking about a question that I get almost every day, which is, which kind of adapter do I need for my trip to Iceland? So let's get into it. For the purposes of this video, we're gonna break it up into two majorly important topics. The first one is which kind of plug you will need. And the second one is what the heck is the difference between an adapter and a converter? The first thing you need to know about the plugins in Iceland is that they are shaped like so. This is a standard European plug, so you can see that there's two round prongs here. This is what's known as type C or type F. The type C has just the two pins, and then the type F will have two clips on the side. Same thing. Also, really important to note is that Iceland operates on 230 volts. We'll talk about what that means in a second. So, very importantly, if you're traveling to Iceland from either North America or anywhere else in the world that doesn't use the standard European plug, then you are going to need to buy something to help you plug your things in. Next, let's get into the major difference between an adapter and a converter. And I just have to say, you guys, I will take full responsibility for this. I have used those words interchangeably in the past in other videos, and I'm correcting myself today so we can clear up the issue and answer all of your questions about what you're gonna need. An adapter is a device that is going to be, you know, something like so, and it's going to allow you to plug in your plug into the Iceland plug, electrical socket. As an example, this is a standard North American plug, this is a standard European plug. This device allows this to plug in here. Pretty simple. One thing that's very important about an adapter is that it does not convert voltage, just adapts the plug. So an adapter adapts the plug, a converter converts the voltage. We'll talk about a converter in just a second. There are two types of adapters that you can buy. So this is a single adapter, meaning that it can only plug in to one outlet. So you can take your plug, no matter where it's from in the world, and plug it into a European type plug. This, on the other hand, is a multi-adapter. So this means that you can plug any of your plugs into multiple different plugs. So usually they have just a different option to release their plugs, and so you can use it that way. So single adapter, multi-adapter. Let's talk about what these will be good for. So an adapter is good for basic items, such as charging your phone, camera, or computer. Usually those items have very basic similar voltages that can be charged through different electrical outlets. And if that sounds like you and anything that you need, I have linked my favorite adapter below in the description, so check it out if you need an adapter for your Iceland trip. The next item is called a converter. So this is where things get a little bit more complicated, but again, it's not that difficult. We just need to clarify. A converter is an item that converts voltage. The voltage coming out of the wall in North America is between 110 to 120 volts. The voltage coming out of the wall in Iceland, Europe, and most countries around the world range from 220 to 240 volts. So this is a huge difference, you guys. This is where I have blown up converters or adapters because I didn't pay attention to the voltage. Learn from my mistakes. So what we have to do is simply check the device that you're trying to plug in. All devices will list on it the voltage that they're rated for. So all you have to do is look inside the device. This one is really hard to see, you can't see, but it's rated at 120 to 240 volts. This means that I can use this device in North America and in Europe because it's rated for both voltages. So because I've lived in Europe for so long, I now have all European plugs. So this is made to plug in Iceland, but as a reference, I could also buy an adapter and use this in the US when I travel back to see my family. Bonus. However, when I first moved to Iceland, I blew up a straightener and two blow dryers because I just thought I was doing it wrong or something. I don't know. So all you want to do is make sure to check what your device is rated for. So again, devices like your cell phone and your computer, those will all have ratings listed on them. So you just check it and check to see, do I need an adapter or do I need a converter? Reasons that you would need a converter. You would need to convert your voltage if you're planning on bringing hair equipment. So usually the guys do not have to worry about this, but for the ladies who are always asking me about hair dryers, straighteners, curling irons, things like that, then you will most likely have to get a converter if you want to use those tools in Iceland. Now, I did want to talk about the point that most accommodations in Iceland will have a hairdryer included. So if you're someone that wants to use a hairdryer on your trip, then consider forgoing the whole converter thing and voltage altogether so that you can keep things really, really simple. I understand wanting to make your hair look nice, but just remember, like, the weather in Iceland is not really conducive for keeping beautiful hair all the time. So I don't know. I usually don't do my hair very often unless I'm filming YouTube videos, but to each his own. You guys just have to know the difference and what you need for your own trip. Just as a reminder, if you don't have the right voltage conversion, then you're at risk for blowing up your own device, melting the converter, or even worse, starting an electrical fire. So please check the rating before you travel and decide to use these things. So as a summary, basic things, plug-in wise, you're going to just need an adapter. So if it's rated 110 to 120, if it's rated higher, then you will need a converter. Don't blow up your things, people. Stay safe. All right, my friends, that is the A to your Q about electrical outlets in Iceland. I hope you guys love this video. Make sure to subscribe for new tips every week. So I'll see you next week, friends. Happy planning.